the ground.
Mother and father had to cling on to each other to make sure they didn't fall over.
The naughty cat has given my poor little Humbert indigestion. Quickly, father, call an ambulance. Father did what he was told. He rushed out of the bedroom to the downstairs telephone. Hello? I need an ambulance. Please, it's my baby son. He's just eaten the cat. No, the cat wasn't cooked. It was raw. Ah! Came a cry from upstairs. This was followed by a thunderous burp. And I think he may have just eaten my wife. Yes, raw. Please, can you come as fast as you can? Father slammed the telephone down and dashed upstairs. Opening the bedroom door, he saw that his wife's feet were just poking out of his baby son's mouth. Humbert munched on his mother's pink fluffy slippers.
Burp! Right in front of his father's eyes, Humbert was getting bigger and bigger and bigger. It was as if the baby was a lilo being inflated. The bed collapsed under his weight. Crunch!
Unsteadily, Humbert rose to his feet. The baby was now taller than father, and his head hit the ceiling. A blizzard of plaster filled the room. Thud! Through the cloud, father could make out his baby son advancing towards him, gobbling up everything in sight.
A shelf of books. Burp! An armchair. Burp! The dressing table. Burp!
Panic flashed across his father's face. In that moment, he realised something. Something terrible. He was next. Nino, Nino! The ambulance was near. Father had to get out of the house, and fast.
He slid down the banister. Whoosh!
And reached the front door. Frantically, he started unlocking it. Looking back, he glimpsed Humbert hurtling down the stairs on his giant bottom, sending pictures on the wall flying. Smash, bang, wallop. If Humbert didn't eat his father, he was sure to flatten him. Still in his mustard-soaked pyjamas, the man dashed out of the front door, slamming it behind him. But that didn't stop Herbert. Oh no. The baby smashed through the front wall of the house.
Kaboom! Sending bricks tumbling through the air, they fell to the ground all around father. Thud, thud, thud. With the front wall gone, the whole house began to crumble. Crack! And collapse to the ground in an explosion of dust and debris. Father ran and hid behind a bush.
Nino, Nino! The ambulance screeched to a halt outside what was left of the family home. As soon as it had stopped, Humbert lumbered over to it. He picked up the ambulance with ease. Ah! Screamed the ambulance driver as he leapt out of the door, landing on the ground with a thud. Oof! He looked up in horror as the giant baby crushed the ambulance with his bare hand. Crunch! Wah! Humbert was hungry again. He took a humongous bite out of the ambulance. Burp! And another. Burp! Until he'd swallowed it down. Burp! Father was still hiding behind the bush, but decided it would be safer to make a run for it. He raced down the street, but the giant baby thundered after him.
Boom! 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 Each step was like an earthquake. Herbert grabbed a passing poodle and ate that. Burp. The little old lady out walking the poodle didn't let go of the lead, so she was gobbled up too. Father ran and ran. Still, the giant baby chased him. A tree was upended and munched into a pulp. Burp. Then a double-decker bus was gobbled up. Burp.
Next, a squad of police cars raced down the road. They stopped in formation to create a roadblock. One by one, the cars were tossed up in the air and caught in the baby's mouth like peanuts.
Humbert grew bigger and bigger and bigger the more he ate. He was now the size of a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Father ran across the bridge to the city.
There, he hoped the baby could not catch him. However, the city just meant more things for Humbert to eat. Streetlights, statues, cars, lorries, even a fire engine was gobbled up in one gulp. Up ahead, Father spotted a very tall building. It must have been 1,000 floors high. Right at the top, he was sure to be out of reach of his ravenously hungry baby son. There was a glass lift at the side of the building. Father frantically pressed the button for floor 1,000 and began travelling up at speed. In the safety of the lift, the man breathed a sigh of relief. Ping! The lift jolted as it reached the very top of the building. The doors slid open and Father rushed out onto the roof. When he looked down, he saw that the giant baby was scaling the building. No! Screamed Father. The man heard a noise. He turned around. A police helicopter was buzzing overhead. The pilot leaned out with a loud hailer.
Giant baby thing, please make your way down to street level and stop eating everything.
Humbert reached out to grab the helicopter. He swatted it like a fly. As it began falling to the ground, the giant baby grabbed the helicopter and ate it. Burp! In no time, Humbert had climbed to the top of the building. Father was trapped. The baby's ginormous hand reached onto the roof and scooped up the man.
Don't eat me, he pleaded. I am your father.
But the baby just smiled, baring his gums. Ah! Screamed the man as he disappeared into the baby's mouth. But the baby spat him out. Yuck! The mustard! Exclaimed Father, scrambling to his feet on the roof of the building. Slipping over on the spicy sauce had saved his life. Just then, three fighter jets whizzed past.
Don't shoot! Shouted Father. All we need to do is coat every man, woman and child in the world in mustard and we will be fine.
The baby reached out and grabbed one of the fighter jets. He munched it down. Burp. And another. Burp. The pilot of the third jet started to fly off at speed. Humbert reached to grab it. As he did, he lost his balance.
No!
Screamed Father as the big baby tumbled to the ground.
Wah!
Humbert, the hungry baby, was no more. So what is the moral of this story? Well, it's very simple. However hungry you are, never try to eat three fighter jets in one sitting. Two are more than enough. Goodbye.